marching order ng presidente kahit piso, no tolerance to corruption tayo. Pasensya na kayo. Yeah. Those are almost occurrences every day. Yun yung galit sila. Because they used to save millions of pesos every shipment. Now they have to pay their dues. See? And every day. So these are the things that we are confronted every day. That confronts us every day. Yung ganyan. Yung kalakaran nila na palakasan. No, hindi pwede. The officials that are with me today, is they are really very serious about it. I cannot do this without them. See, they're the ones that really implementing this reform. They just asked me about, you know, the president is, the number one issue with the president is corruption. Dapat not ano term niya, not ano yung out of corruption, dapat wala ka, or he will kick you out. That's really the issue here. So you really cannot sit here as a commissioner if you have reasons to be a corrupt person. You can't deal with the people here. Hindi ka tatagal, maghapon ka lang, he will succumb to corruption. Siguro. Maybe they see that I am not fit in this job. I give that to them. That is their claim. And I respect them. And I'm again telling you this. I know nothing about customs. I only know one thing, just to say no to you if you try to corrupt this bureau. Yun lang alam ko.
So, will you wait as formal night?
No, because this is not a job. This, when I was asked to do this, this is specifically a mission for me to fix. See? They can kick me out anytime, but this is a mission for me. I'm a soldier. I said yesterday I will not quit from a mission, but you can always kick me out anytime. See, that's not my. You know me. For those of you, I once I am engaged in something, mamatay tayo. We will continue that fight until death. You know that. Nakausap ko siya ng May 30 and I informed him that initially we have seen that there's a neglect of duty in your part, so I'm suspending you. So I also advise him, he's a lawyer, but I also advise him, find a good lawyer because we have a strong case against you. Now, it is a neglect of duty. The system is still working, but it is the inaction of that officer to put those data that will be detected by the parameters, that why it went green. This is the question. Bakit nakalusot? Yeah, nakalusot siya. The shipment arrived in May 17, it was released in May 23, then 26 na huli natin. Bakit nakalusot? Dahil dumaan siya sa green lane. Not express lane, not super green lane. Green lane, dumaan siya na. Next, pag green lane ka kasi, normal process, just pass, just pay your dues, and then labas ka na. Now, bakit siya dumaan doon? Eh, drugs yan. Unang-una, hindi naman drugs na kalagay. Footwear, dineclare. So, itong risk management system is just a document analysis. It analyzes the document. Ngayon, pag yung dokumento mo ay tama naman ang pagkakasulat, ay hindi naman niya automatic yan ang i-re-read. Now, para mag-read siya, there are parameters established. Specifically, EMT is a new importer. So there are two parameters na pwedeng mag-red sa EMT. Pangalawa is sole proprietor. Under the existing parameters, when this EMT shipment arrived, is two. New, importer, and single proprietor. Ngayon, itong RMO office did not encode the data na pag dumaan siya dun sa risk management system, it can be detected by the two parameters and automatically mag-re-read siya. So, yun yung neglect of duty. Hindi yun nalagay, those parameters. Pero, those datas.
Base sa investigation, posibleng neglect of duty lang ba itong sinag-quote or posibleng kasabwat din siya?
We will not conclude sa usapin yan. That's why I asked for an investigation of an independent body. You know, even the result of our investigation will be very truthful because it is Bureau of Customs. Nobody's going to believe in that. So what I did is to recommend to... I wrote a letter last week to the Secretary General of our organization, the World Customs Organization, because it is the World Customs Organization who are real expert in this. So he had already responded to me, we have exchanges of emails already, even the head that we're going to conduct the investigation. The enforcement group head of the World Customs Organization and his team will be going here soon to investigate this system. They will study the system, not the criminal liabilities of people. They will not mess up with that, but this system, so that we can determine exactly if there was tampering and if this system is still working, everything. Now, for your question is, as far as we have seen today, there is a real neglect of duty. Aside from that, we are still looking for it. Showbiz mga tayo. I have a very beautiful fiancé. I love her. So, on the night of that, ayaw na mga congressman, di tayo magsabi ng totoo. In the night of that 25th, of course, we're on date eh. Yeah, no. The details of that, I evoke my right to remain silent. For privacy. Right to privacy na lang. So, pagka umaga, I have to move to Bulacan. And I need a lawyer who can advise me on the specifics of the law. And she's a lawyer, so. Please join me there and please brief me about the specifics of the law that covers this operation so that I know how to handle it. That's just it. That's why she advises me. The rules of evidence and other laws that covers that operation. Just, yun lang yun. Hindi nga nakaligo nung pumunta ka mo rin. Galit na galit eh. But she was on handy kasi magkasama kami. And, girlfriend ko, siyempre masaya ako na she got absent from her routine for that day para lang samahan ako doon. That's just it. Yeah. And on yung issue ng mapanganib daw yung raid, hindi na po mapanganib, that is because 10 hours na yun after several teams of our operatives have occupied the area. So there's no more danger. But even then, she enjoys practical shooting. She shoots well. So she can also defend herself. Yeah. Simple lang kung sinasabi yung kadalasan, I will check if there is irregularity in the assessment done in your shipment. Pero talagang wala naman eh. So pag tumawag uli, sasabihin ko lang, ayaw ni Presidente talaga ng corruption. So hindi namin mapapigyan yung request mo kasi tama po yung assessment. Kailangan nyo pong magbayad. Kailangan nyo pong taasan yung bayad nyo. Eh tapos kung mababaw yung minsan kasi maybe timbang kilos yung basihan, less than 20% yung kilo niya, eh siyempre kinikilo natin yan eh, yung mga mabibigat, mga tires. So in-explain natin, please correct it. So yun yung ginagawa natin. Dati, nakakalusot yan eh. But under our watch, we will not allow it. So this one, ito yung hinaharap natin dito araw-araw. 10,000 containers every day are coming into this country. And 12,000 importers, gusto makatipid niyan eh. E makatipid siya ng 1 million every shipment, that's still 1 million. E makatipid siya ng 10 million every shipment, that's still 10 million. That is what we are being confronted every day. Yun yung problema. And again, itong mga nasuspendin natin, mga kaibigan ko ng mga matatalik here, the 800 that have been previously enjoying what they've been doing here, eh every day talaga nakikita ko yan, pwede na akong... Diba? Nawalan sila ng hanap buhay eh. But kasalanan nila. They repeatedly did it eh. In other countries, isang beses ka lang magpa-credit. Permanent, yeah, lifetime. But even the smallest infraction against the law, importation law, permanent ka na rin mawawala ng accreditation. And that is what we want to implement here. I need the support of the public, and of course, the officials that has supervision over this bureau. No, I will not interfere with the process of the inquiry by the Senate and the Congress. And even if there will be a body to conduct a full-blown investigation, I will not interfere because I am not an investigating individual. So let the group or the body that conducts the investigation handle him. Isa pa pala, no? There's this a disagreement between the concept of operation during the delivery of this controlled delivery. Okay, let me make this very clear. All of the pronouncement of Director Wilkins Villeneuve of PDEA are true. Napagpasok niya, galit na galit ako. Tama yan. Alas, siya rin nagsabi na dito sa amin sa customs, ginagawa namin ang tama. Contextually, correct siya. But this is the specific term I said. Let's do this correctly as it is. Huwag natin baguhin yung katotohanan. Let's conduct this operation truthfully. Who are inside that room? I called for Estrella, the head of the customs, the lady lawyer of NBI, and Director Wilkins Villanueva, and told them that I want the delivery of only one cylinder na lang. Why? There are several reasons. Hindi tayo pinapatapos. Yan ang problema dyan sa inquiry sa Congress. Isang linya pa lang, puputulin ka na. So your explanation, hindi mo masasabi. There are several reasons why. First, PDEA operatives were informed 9 a.m. They arrived there past 1 o'clock. That's more than 4 hours since we informed them. Okay, that's even longer than the time we received the information from China and the time we already operated it. Because we got those crates within 3 hours when we got confirmed, considering that gabi pa po yun. Okay, so if he arrived earlier, those procedural errors that we have committed could have been corrected earlier. And I accept yung sinasabi niya, there are several procedural errors of the Bureau. That is exactly true. The evidences were contaminated by some people because they don't have gloves. That is accurate. Some people have take pictures with those drugs. That is accurate. All his pronouncements are accurate. But there are facts that he did not mention. And my reasons for disagreeing with his concept. Okay, these are the reasons. First, I want Mr. Chen, the owner of that warehouse, to be charged. Because doon po nahuli yung ano eh. Under the Dangerous Act, this is their law, their own law. Anybody who helps facilitate the importation, transportation of any drugs, whatever amount and purity, the maximum punishment po niyan ay life imprisonment. So naturally, Mr. Chen, the owner of that warehouse, and the consignee, he's already a suspect, and that's why I want part of the drugs to stay there as an evidence against that owner of the warehouse. Because the controlled delivery we are conducting, hindi tayo sigurado kung mahuli pa natin si Anochi D. Because umaga pa lang, hinihintay na niya yung drugs. We keep waiting for the people that's supposed to have the mandate to do it. So magdidilim na, hindi pa nagagawa. And we disagree. They want all. Narinig niyo siya. He wanted all na dadalhin doon. I do not want every drugs na dadalhin mo doon. Pag hindi namin nahuli si Anochi D, ibabalik namin yung drugs yun. That's a bigger legal problem. And then makakawala ngayon si Mr. Chen. That's why today, we still have a case against Chen. Because 500 kilos that was left there is, per the record, nahuli doon sa kanyang warehouse. Now today, lumalabas sa investigation that Chen could probably the real corporate kill. That's why, those are the reasons why I wanted it divided Hindi dadalhin lahat. So I stand by that decision, and if the situation will comes to, arises today, I will still do the same decision. So yun po yung disagreement namin ni PDEA. So the PDEA are the experts. Let us recognize that. They are the experts. But this is just a disagreement on the concept. And it just common sense to me. Okay? Oh yes, dahil mga senior natin yan eh. Oh, they are all seniors. They are the experts. So I understand the sentiment of Director Wilkins, because he's the expert there, and a non-expert has opposed his decision, but I stand by that decision. That's why that's the purpose of our command center, for every law enforcement representative to be part of that command center. So once our office here will be fixed, in a few more months, they will now have a permanent place there. So yun yung intention, that's really the intention, to invite them to be permanently embedded, their representative, in all the activities of the Bureau. Other details, I do not know if this can be discussed, so we talk about other things. I didn't get a authorization to discuss that. I just talk about the main issues that I'm sure you're very expected to know. Again, performance pala. You know, hindi nila masyadong pinapansin eh. For the first 1 year, ano bang performance? Efficiency ng Bureau of Customs, 97.3. Ano ba ang attrition law or passing rate? 92%. So we are way, way above the attrition law. We are 97.3% average in the first 1 year. So let me make this very clear, because there are some legislators who were fed wrong information. So this can be verified sa Bureau of Treasury, because diretso naman dun yung pera, at saka sa finance. The first 1 year of President Duterte's term of revenue efficiency is 97.3. So napakataas po nun. In the entire world, find a bureau that attains 100% and go to me. Pakainin kita ng border. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.